is how to apply skin traction. A traction is defined as an act of drawing or exerting a pulling force applied to limbs, bones or other tissues along the longitudinal axis of the structure to pull the tissues apart, often for realignment. In a skin traction, the traction force is applied over a large area of skin. The traction of the skin, the traction of the limb must be applied to the limb distant to the practice site, and the traction weight is 10% of the body weight with a maximum body weight of around 6.7 kg. Indications for a skin traction include temporary management of a femoral neck fracture, management of a femoral shaft fracture in older and healthy children after reduction of a dislocation of a hip, to prevent minor fixed flexion deformities of the hip or knee, for management of lower back ache, and post a diligent amputation to approximate the tissue. Contraindications include abrasion of the skin, laceration of the skin, dermatitis, and when the traction weight required is greater than the maximum permissible limit. The materials required for a skin traction include soft roll, bus traction pulley, some weights, traction kit, and crepe bandage. A below knee skin traction extends from two fingers below the tibial tuberosity to two fingers above the medial mandibles. We'll start by covering the bony prominences with a soft roll to prevent any sort of pressure ulcers or sores. If you don't have a soft roll, you can also use a cotton roll instead of it. Once you have applied the soft roll, you'll take a traction kit and you'll apply it at the foot end. The foot end of the traction kit is made with a sponge so as to allow flexion and extension at the ankle joint. Once you have applied the traction kit firmly, we'll take a crepe bandage. And we'll cover the traction kit. Make sure that each rotation of the crepe bandage covers one third of the previous rotation. Also, one should be sure that the pressure applied is not too much, as it can lead to neurovascular abnormalities or compartment syndrome. After the application of a crepe bandage, you'll take the rope from the foot end of the traction kit and you'll pass it through the bus traction pulley. The angle of the bus traction pulley is adjustable as per the accordance of the counter traction you require. Once you have adjusted the angle as per your requirement, you'll take the rope at the foot end and you'll tie it with the calculated weight. It should be made sure that the weights which are suspended are at the midpoint between the bed and the floor for proper traction. Like this. And that's how you apply the skin traction. It is important to monitor the traction, to see if the skin is healthy, to record neurovascular abnormalities every hour, and it should be monitored twice a day for any sort of pressure sores or ulcers. A complication of skin traction includes excoriation of the skin, pressure sores at the bony prominences, common peroneal nerve palsy, and compartment syndrome. Thank you.
Dr. Sir, audience might like to ask you a question. Anybody, please?
The bus traction pulley, which is used, that is used for the counter traction. The angle is adjusted. In the video I have shown below the bed. Just a second.
So by elevating or decreasing the head, what you intend to achieve? And if they help you in some way?
That's how the traction is calculated according to the weight of the patient. According to, because the weight of the patient will act as a counter traction.